Okay, so next problem on the practice test. This is going to be problem B. And this one says runner A, initially 5.9 kilometers west of a flagpole, is running with a constant velocity of 8.3 kilometers per hour due east. And then you've got runner B, that is 4.1 kilometers east, and he's running with a constant velocity of 8 kilometers due west. All right, we're going to set this up on a position versus time graph. And since all the distance measurements are given from the flag, from the flagpole, our flagpole is going to be our zero. That's going to be the reference point for the graph. It doesn't really matter which way you pick to be positive or negative. I'm just going to pick west to be my positive direction, since that's the first thing they talk about is west. I've got this object that is initially 5.9 kilometers to the west, and he's running to the east. And then I've got this other person that is initially 4.1 to the east. Now he's on the other side of the flagpole, so this is going to be negative 4.1 for the initial position, and he's running the opposite way. You've got to have your two people running opposite ways, because if they're not, they're never going to meet each other. Okay, go all around, way around the earth and come back, but they're never going to meet each other if they don't run in opposite directions. The velocities would be the slopes of the lines here. So the 5.9, he was running at 8.3 kilometers. So the slope here is going to be negative 8.3. And then the slope of the other one, he's running at 8 kilometers. So that slope is going to be 8. So I'm getting all of my information on the graph. So it's easy to look at it and see all of that information all at once. You want to know when and where they meet. That's going to be the intersection of those two lines. So if you can write the equations for those two lines, you ought to be able to figure out where the intersection of those two lines are. Now, the equations for the lines, you can just think y equals mx plus b, just algebra one, write the equation for the lines. But that also matches with saying the position of the object is equal to its velocity times time plus its initial position. Velocity and initial position are going to be numbers. We're going to write the equation for the position of object one with respect to time. Object one, that'll be my first guy. His velocity is negative 8.3. Then I've got the t as part of the equation, plus the initial position, which is 5.9. 5.9. I just left the units off. You want to double check and make sure the units are all the same. Everything's in kilometers and hours, so we don't have to convert anything. So for simplicity's sake, I'll just leave the units off of that. That's going to be the equation for the position of person number one. Person number two, or person B, I guess I should call them A and B. Person B, his velocity is 8, positive 8. His initial position is a negative 4.1. So I've got the equation then for position with respect to time for my two people. And then the key to this is to realize that when they meet each other, they're at the same place at the same time. So the position of A is going to be equal to the position of B. So I'm going to set my two equations equal to each other. So negative 8.3t plus 5.9 is equal to 8t minus 4.1. Now, what you want to make sure is true is if you look at your equations, the one that has a positive initial position has a negative velocity, and the one that has a negative initial position has a positive velocity. You could have set it up differently. You could have flipped your east and west positive and negative, but regardless of how you did it, it has to be true that positive initial position goes with the negative velocity, negative initial position goes with the positive velocity. All right, when you're sure that's right, then we're down to this equation. There's only one unknown in this equation. We don't know what the time is. Okay, so I'm going to get my like terms together. I'm going to take 5.9 and I'm going to put that together with the 4.1. So I'm adding 4.1 to both sides. And goodness, what is 5.9 plus 4.1? Is that 10? So we add those together and that's going to give me 10. And then I'm going to take my 8.3 over to the other side. So I'm going to add 8.3. So 8 and 8, 16. So I'm going to get 16.3 times the time. And then divide both sides. Now you're going to divide both sides by the 16.3. Be careful that you don't fall into the habit of just dividing the bigger number by the little number. Okay. We want to isolate the t by itself. So we're getting rid of that 16.3. So 10 divided by 16.3 gives me 0.613. And that should give me my time when these guys meet. And that's going to be in hours. So that's the time when they meet. But be careful because the question wants to know how far are the runners from the flagpole. So at this point, we know when they meet, but we don't know where they are when they meet. So we have to take this time and plug it back in to figure out where they are. Now here's the question. Do I take it and plug it back in here, or do I take it and plug it back in there? Doesn't matter. They should be at the same place at that time. So you can plug it back into either one that you like, and if you've got time, plug it back into both of them. You should get the same position. Now, realizing there might be a little bit of rounding going on, so it might not be exactly the same, depending on if things are rounded a bit. And this is kind of a funny number, so they might not be quite exactly the same. But we take that, and I think I'll just plug it back into this one. So I'm going to take my 0.613, multiply it by 8, and then subtract the 4.1, and I end up with a position for object B of 0.81, and that should be in, what is this thing, in kilometers. Okay. And that's going to be the solution to the problem because that tells you where they are. I did get a positive value for that. You want to realize what that positive value means is that they are west of the flagpole because I made west be my positive direction. So getting a positive value for the position tells me that they are west of the flagpole. And if somebody had set things up differently, they would still get west of the flagpole. So their negative might tell them west. My positive tells me west, and those things should match. Any questions on that one?